Good morning, my dear students. Again, coming to the new topic, that is undamped force vibration of a spring mass system. Okay, so here I am going to tell you about the concept of undamped force vibration. Okay, so here you are going to use some force vibration, that is external force, to create a vibration. Okay, so how that vibration going to take place and how we are going to derive the some equations present in the undamped force vibration. Okay, so that I am going to explain you now here. Okay, so normally take any mechanical system, okay, the mechanical system that are not undergo any of the free vibration, okay, but we are going to subject some external forces, that is, if you want to apply some external force, there is a chance of the particular given system to vibrate. Okay, so in this section, what I am going to explain you is we are going to consider only the harmonic force, okay, that is in terms of sine and cosine, okay, cosine forces. Okay, harmonic force nothing but what, if you are using in a force equation that is sine or cos, that is called as a harmonic force, that is F naught sine omega t or F cos omega t, both. Okay, but any changing the force can produce a vibration, not only the harmonic force. You can take some external force or some any other force, we are going to that particular component going to what produce a vibration. Okay, when we consider the free body diagram of the this spring system, that is a spring mass system, we know that we are going to apply some additional forces on that particular component to create or to generate or to get the excitation harmonic force. Okay, so here I am going to use a spring, that is a mass spring system, with an external force F applying on the harmonic excitation. Okay, so this is a spring mass system. Okay, so here we are going to apply some external force, that is F naught. Okay, here it is going to apply the externally. Okay, so from just to give some displacement, it will displace some position. Okay, that is x naught. This is x nothing but for the displacement. Okay, so this is a spring denoted by k, and this is a fixed position. Okay, so this is shape is a fixed position. Okay, so here we are going to apply some excitation harmonic force. Then what is the equation, final equation, and how the amplitude going to changes, or whether it is changes or whether it is going to decrease, that we need to study in this section. Okay, so here the normally we know that the equation of motion of the forced vibration, this is equal to what, mx double dot plus kx is equal to f. F is nothing but what, then external harmonic force. Okay, so this external force, harmonic force, we are going to apply here. So this equation I am going to consider. Okay, according to the Newton's second law, you have to write here mx double dot plus kx is equal to some external force. Okay, external force is nothing but what, a harmonic force, we are going to apply the externally, not that from the component. Okay, so that force we are going to take on as what, F is equal to F naught sine omega t. Okay, so sine, if you are using sine and cos in this position, that is called as what, the harmonic force. Okay, so here F is equal to, where F is equal to what, F is equal to F naught sine omega t. So this much of force, okay, this force I am going to applying this this position, that is externally. Okay, so now so the equation of motion of the system can be written in the given standard form, that is x double dot plus k by m x is, which is equal to f naught m sine omega t. Okay, so sine omega t, so here you are going to divide this f. Okay, that is this, from this equation you have to divide m, so you are going to get this equation. Okay, x double dot plus k by m into x, which is equal to f naught by m sine omega t. Okay, the solution of this system consists of the two superposition of the principle, that is the two superposition of the solution. One is what, the particular solution, and one more is a complementary solution. Okay, the total the general solution we are going to get what, here total we are going to get what, the particular solution and the complementary solution. Okay, so particular solution is nothing but what, related to the force function. Okay, if you apply the force on that particular component, that going to consider as a particular solution, and the complementary solution is nothing but which is the solution of the system without forcing. Okay, so here in this we are not going to apply any force, that is we are going to consider as a xe. Xe stands for the complementary function, and xv nothing but the particular function. Okay, so upon which we are going to apply some force. Okay, so if you want to get the total solution, we have to add these two values. Okay, and that is xp plus xc, that is which gives what, the total complete solution of the this undamped spring mass system. Okay, so the complete solution of the solution is given by what, the we can going to get the what, x general solution, x is equal to xc plus, that is the complementary function, plus the particular function. Okay, so we can obtain the particular solution by assuming the solution of the form of this, the particular solution which is there in the mechanical component is equal to d sine of omega t. Okay, so this equation is the particular solution equation which is there in the mechanical component, that is the device. Okay, where omega naught is what, the frequency of the harmonic force forcing the function. Okay, so here this much of force, that angle will be creating, you see omega naught by t, this much angle is with respect to the horizontal line, with respect to time, and d sine of this is a harmonic force. Okay, we differentiate this form of the solution, then the sub into the above equation of the motion. Okay, so again we have to differentiate this. Okay, So x of p is equal to what? So again you have to differentiate this equation. Okay, x of p is equal to d sin omega t. Okay, so in the previous case I used here f. Okay, so x of p is equal to what? Minus omega naught t. So this zero should become this side. Okay, minus omega naught t d sin omega t. Okay, so now you substitute this equation into that. Okay, that is minus m omega naught m omega square naught d sin omega t plus k d sin omega naught t, which is equal to f sin omega naught t. Okay, so that is, this is what you have substitute this equation in that equation, you are going to get this minus m omega naught square d sin of omega naught t plus k of d sin omega naught t, which is equal to, this is an harmonic force f naught sin omega naught t. Okay, so this is an harmonic force, external force. Because of force, this equation I wrote this equation. Okay, solving for the d, where d and this is where what, the constant term. Okay, solving the for the d, we find the d and the particular solution, that is xp. So d is equal to f naught by k, okay, divided by 1 minus omega naught by omega n whole square. Okay, so x of p is equal to what? Same equation, you have to continuation this f naught p. Okay, particular solution f naught by k into 2 sin of omega naught t divided by 1 minus omega naught into omega n. Okay, so for the general solution of the forced vibration undamped system which is given by, you have to combine both the equation, that is xp and xc, you are going to get this equation. Okay, you are going to get general solution. Okay, so g stands for general solution, x of g of t, which is equal to, this is a particular solution and complementary solution. Okay, if you both add, so this is a particular function you write as it is, plus this is a general solution. Okay, so where phi stands for the phase angle. Okay, so we are going to consider this phase angle while solving the problem, and this equation is very, very important for the while solving the problems on undamped force vibration. Okay, x of t is equal to f naught by k divided by 1 minus omega naught omega n. Okay, angular frequency, omega n nothing but what, the angular frequency, okay, into sin of omega naught t plus c of sin omega n t plus phi. Okay, so if you look at this, this is the final equation. Okay, so the same, if you want to get the total general solution, I drawn the that is a graph. Okay, this is called as a complementary solution and particular solution. Okay, so this is draw the complementary function, displacement with respect to time. Okay, so here look at the diagram. Here we are not going to reduce any of the reduction of the amplitude. Okay, it is, which is equal to the interval. Okay, so look at here also. Okay, and with a very short distance, whereas in the particular solution, so again here we are going to get the maximum amplitude, large amplitude. Okay, and at a large distance. Okay, same you are going to consider. Okay, particular function, so here you are going to apply the some force, but here you are not going to use. Okay, so if you get the total general solution, okay, so you have combined both the solution, you are going to get the general solution. Okay, this, you have to merge these two diagram, this and this, you are going to add these two solution, you are going to get the solution. Okay, general solution. Okay, so the blue color shows the general solution for the undamped spring mass system. Okay, the above figure shows that the two responses at a different frequencies. Recall that the value of omega n comes from the physical characteristic of the system, that is in place of m and k, that is mass and stiffness, and omega naught comes from the force being applied to the system. Okay, so that omega naught we are going to get the after applying the forces on that particular devices. Okay, these two responses are summed, that is to merge, to achieve a blue response, that is called the general solution for the given component. Okay, so like this you have to derive equation. Okay, so this is very important. Okay, omega n is nothing but what here, the angular frequency. Okay, so just you have to, in this equation what you have to remember is general solution plus complementary, that is what, the general solution which is equal to what, the complementary solution plus particular solution. Okay, that if you have to derive, means just to summarize, that is summed, you are going to get the final answer. Okay, so I hope you understand this undamped forced vibration of the spring mass system. Okay, so look at here, in the question only, here we are going to use what, here they are telling that undamped and that, so you are not going to use the damping system. Okay, so if you are not using damping, means there is no reduction of amplitude. Okay, so this is about the undamped force vibration of a spring mass system. Okay, so this is a diagram. So according to the general solution of the equation of motion, mx double dot plus kx is equal to f, so where is the f, is the external force. Okay, you have to write here. Okay, the external force is equal to, in the harmonic equation, f naught sin omega t. So substitute in that equation, you are going to get the final solution. Okay, so like this you have to derive the equation of the motion of the system, can be written as, so again same here you have to divide this. Okay, m x dot plus kx, it is equal to f, you substitute here, if you are divide this m, so you are going to get what, x dot plus k by m x, which is equal to f naught by m sin of omega t. Okay, So here the particular solution related to the forcing function xp is really after applying the force, x is without applying the force. Okay, again where d is some constant, we have to find that. Okay, xp is equal to d sine of omega naught t. Okay, so this omega naught t is nothing but the angle which is present in the mechanical system. Okay, so that if you draw the vector representation, this we are going to show there. Okay, this is an phase angle. Okay, so while solving the problem, they may give some values here, 95 degree, 45 degree. Okay, that you have to consider. Again for the particular sum function, again you have to differentiate this, we are going to get this. Okay, x double dot p, so you are going to get, again you have to substitute, so you are going to get this equation. So where d and d are the particular solution that is of xp. Okay, here d is equal to what, f naught, d is equal to what, f naught sine omega t. Okay, so that place you have to replace this. Okay, you are going to get this. So if you refer the for notes for this equations. Okay, so finally you are going to combine those two equations, that is complementary solution plus complementary solution and the general solution. Okay, so you combine those two, means you are going to get the final answer. Okay, so this is the general solution for this. So x of general solution of f naught by k, so this is particular solution. Okay, x of p is equal to f naught by f naught divided by k, 2 sine of omega naught t divided by 1 divided by 1 minus omega naught omega n. Okay, this is square root. Okay, the general solution is what, particular function plus complementary. Okay, f naught by k, so divided by 1 minus omega naught omega n, whole, that is a square. Okay, so here square will be there. Okay, into sine of omega naught into sine of omega naught t plus the sine of omega n t plus phi. Okay, so here square will be there. Okay, if you substitute, you are going to get the final answer. Okay, so I hope you understand this under damped spring mass system. So you have to derive this equation. Okay, refer notes for more step simplification. Okay, so I hope you understand this. Thank you.